नेक्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू सी द मैग्नेटिक फोर्सेस ओके व्हिच अकर ड्यू टू मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो हियर वी हैव थ्री वेज इन विच फोर्स कैन बी अप्लाइड ड्यू टू मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ओके. दिस फर्स्ट वन इज ड्यू टू मूविंग चार्ज पार्टिकल इन अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. And then next one on a current element in an external field. And then next third one is due to between two current elements. First one, moving charge particle of a magnetic field. Due to current element, presence of current element in the external field. Then third one is due to two current elements. Okay, presence of two current elements will exhibit a force on the magnetic field. Okay. So now we are going to see the Lorentz force equation. Okay. This will be seen in point charge. In previous chapter, that is static electric field, electrostatic electric field will exert a force on a static as well as moving charge cube. So static movement illadappo moving cube patina will exhibit or exert a force in the electric field. Okay, this is considered this law is nothing but Coulomb's law. So according to Coulomb's law, you will be writing the force for the electric field. Okay, that is F vector for the electric field will be written as a charge E vector. Charge E vector, Q into E vector. Okay, so the product of charge and electric field will give the force. Okay, N symbol newton, unit. So here the positive charge, the force exerted on it is in the direction of E vector. So this force will be called as an electric force. Now we are going to consider the charge which is going to be placed in a steady magnetic field, static magnetic field. வைக்க போகிறோம். அப்போ என்ன ஆகும், இட் வில் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் எ ஃபோர்ஸ் ஒன்லி வென் இட் இஸ் மூவிங். ஓகே, ஸ்டாட்டிக்ல கிடைக்காது. ஆனால் ஃபோர்ஸ் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா எலக்ட்ரிக் ஃபீல்டில் ஸ்டாட்டிக் போத் ஸ்டாட்டிக் அஸ் வெல் அஸ் மூவிங் சார்ஜுக்கும் கிடைக்கும். ஆனால் இங்கே மேக்னெட்டிக் ஃபீல்டில் ஸ்டாட்டிக்காக இருக்கப்ப கிடைக்காது. மூவிங்காக சார்ஜ் வந்து மூவிங்காக இருக்கும் போது மட்டும்தான் இட் வில் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் எ ஃபோர்ஸ். ஓகே, தட் ஃபோர்ஸ் வில் பி டினோட்டட் அஸ் ஏ எஃப்எம். எஃப்எம் தட் இஸ் மேக்னெட்டிக் ஃபோர்ஸ் is exerted on a moving charge. Okay, moving charge in a moving, for moving, you will be having some velocity. That velocity value will be represented by V vector, small V vector. Okay, so here Fm represents magnetic force that can be written as here Q into V vector, V cross V vector. So in the electric field intensity with the Q charge, away mari you get Q with the magnetic field intensity. Okay, in the V-ங்கிறது velocity will come. Okay, in the இடத்துல velocity வராது. Here velocity will be included, M for unit newton symbol. So இது ரெண்டு ஃபோர்ஸ், இது எலக்ட்ரிக் ஃபீல்ட் ஃபோர்ஸ், இது வந்து மேக்னெட்டிக் ஃபோர்ஸ். So from equation 1, it that the electric force is independent of velocity. Okay, electric force does not have any velocity for the moving charge. Okay, so in other words, we can say that the electric force exert on the moving charge by the electric field is independent of the direction in which the charge is moving. So it will be independent of the direction. That's why here you will not include the velocity in the electric field. But magnetic force la patina you will be including the velocity because it will depend on the velocity of moving charge. Okay. So here magnetic force will perform work on a moving charge as it is right angle to the direction of motion of charge. So movement of charge is this right angle, it is perpendicular unload of force. Okay, charge movement is perpendicular, your force will be exerted or experienced. Okay, that's why we are going to include the velocity in the magnetic force. So Finally, the total force F can be calculated by adding both the force, that is electric force and magnetic force, that is F E vector plus F M vector. So F E vector, F M vector, directly and the two values substitute panninga. Substitute panninga Q value will be common for both. So Q value eduthu meedhi ella terms ye ulla kodunga. So force or unit newton. So the above equation will be called as a Lorentz force equation. Okay, which relates mechanical force to the electrical force. So if the mass of the charge is m, then we can write the force as F equal to ma. So m is mass, a is acceleration. So acceleration is nothing but change in velocity with respect to time. Another mass into dv by dt, change in velocity dv with respect to time. Okay, so that can be equated with your above equation, that is Q. NIF equal to Q into E vector plus V vector cross B vector. Okay. Ipdiyum elathalam. See, actually, in your syllabus, you will be having Lorentz force equation as your first topic in the third unit. Irka, this only we are studying now. Now we are going to see the force between differential color current elements. So already in the first slide it will calculate. Due to presence of two current element, there will exert a force, okay, in the magnetic field. So adeda nama inga paaporam, we are going to see the force on the differential current element. So here we are going to consider two current element, I1 DL1, I2 DL2. So these two are different current elements. See, listen, in the electrostatic field, when your current carrying conductor carries current in the same direction, what will happen means it will be repelling each other. Okay, if the charges are same type in the electrostatic field, then it will repel to each other. But if it is opposite to each other, okay, when your charges, what two charges are opposite to each other, then it will be attracted, okay, in the electrostatic field. Okay, but consider the two current elements carry current which is parallel to each other. Okay, in the electromagnetic field, the current element carrying current in the same direction means it will be attracting to each other. இதே வந்து different directionல current carry பண்ணுச்சுனா it will be repelling. Okay, repel to each other in the magnetostatic field. Okay, so now we are going, for example, now we are going to consider two current elements, I1 into DL1, I2 into DL2, as shown in your figure. Here note the direction of I1 and I2. I1 and I2 going to be in the same direction. Here the both the current elements produce their own magnetic field as the currents are flowing in the same direction through the element. So the force, that is DF1 vector, exerted on the element I1 DL1, first element, due to magnetic field produced by the other element. ஸோ ஒரு ரெண்டு கரண்ட் எலமெண்ட் இருக்கு, ரெண்டு கரண்ட் எலமெண்ட்டும் ஒரே டைரக்ஷனில் சேம் டைரக்ஷனில் கரண்ட் கேரி பண்ணுது. இப்போ வந்து அந்த ஃபோர்ஸ் வந்து எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் பண்ணுவோம் டியூ டு மேக்னெட்டிக் ஃபீல்டு ப்ரெசன்ஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ இப்போ வந்து என்ன பண்ண போகிறோம், கரண்ட் எலமெண்ட் டூ இருக்கு இல்லையா, அந்த கரண்ட் எலமெண்ட்டை வந்து இட் வில் ஜென்ரேட் சம் மேக்னெட்டிக் ஃபீல்ட். ஓகே, that magnetic field, due to the presence of magnetic field, some force will be exerted on the current element 1. Okay, current element 1 la force exert avum experience pannuvom due to the presence of magnetic field due to current element 2. Okay, current element 2 all occur agra force. That's current element 1 la paakaporam. Okay, have you understood? So we are going to write the equation as D of DF1 vector, that is force exerted on a current element 1 is represented by DF1 vector will be equal to I1 into DL1. This is current element. Current element 1 into DB2 vector. It is a magnetic field intensity of current element 2. Okay, enough. Current element 2 is going to produce magnetic field. That is DB2. அதனால வர ஃபோர்ஸ் தான் நம்ம DF1. Okay, அதனால நம்ம இந்த magnetic field intensity for the current element 2 will be considered. Okay. So now we are going to see the Biot-Savart law. The ஏற்கனவே பார்த்த போல அந்த Savart law ஓட equation எடுத்து எழுத போறோம். So அது என்ன? DB2 vector equal to mu naught DH2. இதுதான் Biot-Savart law ஓட equation. இதை நான் வந்து magnetic field intensity B2க்கு apply பண்ண போறேன். So apply பண்றப்ப என்ன ஆகும்? இந்த DH2. DH2 value என்ன? Is DH2 value. Previous Biot-Savart law le paatha polaya I2 DL2. Enna current element o that will be multiplied with your unit vector divided by 4 pi r square. And the formula va inga apply substitute panna. Magnetic field intensity formula va inga substitute panna. Magnetic flux density. Okay. Magnetic flux density formula va inga apply panna. And then substituting the value of DB2 in equation. If in the second equation value were in the substitute panel. Okay, first equation DB2 area vector. Anga substitute panel, what you will be getting? This one. Mu naught into I1 DL1 vector into I2 DL2 vector into unit vector divided by 4 pi r square 2 1. Okay. So here the equation 3 will represent the force between two current elements, okay, which will be similar to your Coulomb's law. So by integrating this, D double D varudhu, appa double integration pannanum, seriya? Double integration pannada unakku F1 vector, simply F1 vector kedaikum. Appa idha nee double integration pandra with respect to L1 and L2, that is current element 1 and current element 2. Okay, so constant term எல்லாம் வெளிய எடுத்துக்கற, you are going to double integrate this values to get the F1 vector. Okay, so exactly following same step we can calculate the force F2 exerted on the current element. இப்போ F1 vector என்றது the force exerted on a first current element due to current element 2. Okay, அடுத்தது வந்து force exerted on a current element 2 due to magnetic field B1 produced by the current element 1. Okay. இதே மாதிரி equation எழுதலாம். So this equation is actually obtained from equation 4 by interchanging the subscript 1 and 2. Okay. Now by using back cap rule. What is back cap rule? Vector triple product la expand pannuvalaya, so based on that you can write the force F2 vector equal to minus F1 vector. Okay, so the above condition will indicate both the force F1 vector and F2 vector will obey Newton's third law. What is Newton's third law? Every action that is equal opposite, equal and opposite reaction. Chariya. So that we are going to conclude that for two current carrying conductor, the force exerted will be commonly written as F equal to mu into I1 into I2 into L, length of the conductor, divided by 2 pi d. Okay, this is the general equation for the conductor which carries, two conductor which carries current in the same direction. Chariya. Next, magnetic dipole moment. So magnetic dipole moment is nothing but product of current through the loop and the area of the loop, which is normal to the current loop, will be defined as a magnetic dipole moment. Simple solna product of current and area. Okay, current and area is represented by IS. Product of current and area. Area is given as a surface here. Area of a surface ning denote panita by S nu kuduttaam. I into S will give the electric magnetic dipole moment. Okay, so AN vector is nothing but it will represent the direction of your dipole moment. Okay, so it is A m square rather unit ampere meter square for the magnetic dipole moment unit. Okay, so you can write the torque equation as here BIS into minus AY vector, which is already seen in your previous chapter, that was given here. So from that you can conclude that you can calculate the torque by using magnetic dipole moment M vector as M vector into B vector. So B vector is the magnetic flux density. Okay, so the product of magnetic flux density with magnetic dipole moment will give you a torque. Okay.